Hey guys, this is Jennifer, and this is the Jennifer Allwood Show, the podcast where you learn how to create a beautiful home and build a creative business. Grab a cup of coffee, find a cozy spot in the house, and let's chat. I'm excited you're here. Hey everyone, welcome back to the podcast again this week. Super excited to have you here again today, and just so grateful for those of you who listen so consistently and you share this podcast with your friends and family. And we're just super grateful over here and just enjoying this podcast so much. So we're going to talk about a fun topic today. We're going to talk about how to know when it's time to quit your day job. So I get this question asked to me a lot, friends. I wish that I could say that there is some magical formula that you could just kind of dump into a program and it'd give you a little reading and tell you a date of quitting your day job or how you could make that happen. And it's not quite as easy as that, but I do have a checklist that I think will really help you in making decisions towards whether or not you should leave your day job to pursue that creative dream that you have. So before we get started, I want to do a quick thank you to our podcast sponsor for this week. This week, our podcast is sponsored by my very own Creators Roadmap course. This is my signature course where I teach creative people the 7 ways that they can make money online. If you're interested about finding out more about those ways when this course reopens on April 30th, you can go to creatorsroadmap.com to get on the waiting list and we will send you an email then. So back to the question, how do you know when it's time to leave your day job? Well, listen, friends, this is really a personal question, and I don't know that there is a perfect answer, but I do know that there are some telltale ways or like kind of like a checklist. So when people call and ask me, or they text me, or they send me a private message, I usually run it through about 6 different things. Okay, six different ways that you can kind of know if you're headed in the direction of quitting your day job. Okay, so let's go through these in no particular order. But if you're someone who's currently at a day job that you're hoping that you can leave to pursue your creative career, just know that we have thousands of listeners who have been in your exact situation. I myself being one of them. And as many of you know, I have a degree in computer-based information systems. So I got my degree when I was 30, and now just a couple days ago at age 30, and graduated top of my class, had a great job doing software development, and started my painting company just as kind of a side gig. And I'm guessing a lot of you can relate to that. Like, it was a really great outlet for me. I enjoyed the creative part of the business. I was good at it. I loved getting my hands dirty. I loved how when I was painting a piece of furniture, that it was almost like therapy to me. And I would be able just to focus solely on what I was doing and just loved it so much, all right? And so for me, I started out my business as someone who was in a day job, just playing around on the nights and weekends. And then something happened. I got laid off from my computer job. And you guys, I boohooed about it for days. And, you know, what am I going to do now? And still thought, well, gosh, I should probably do the responsible thing. And I should continue to put out resumes to other people who are hiring for software developers. And yet in my heart, I kept wondering, okay, but goodness, I really hated that job anyway. Like, this truth, just laying it all out here on the table. Like, I wonder if I could make a full-time thing out of this painting gig. Like, is there any possible way, instead of just pretending, you know, to kind of have a little side business and doing it on occasion on nights and weekends, I wonder if there's any way that I could actually push on the gas and actually try to promote this thing and actually try to do this for a living. And then, of course, all of the things start popping into your head, the things like, but that would be crazy to give up a 401k, and I would be nuts to not have PDOs, and maybe nobody else in my family is an entrepreneur, and I don't know the first thing about business. I just want to paint. And so all of those things are very normal thoughts that go through, I think, a creative person's mind. But that is how I actually took the leap from someone who was dreaming about a business to someone who is now 18 years in on that business. So in my case, I didn't quit my day job in pursuit of the creative career. What actually happened is I was pushed out of that day job, and God gave me a door that was open And I walked through it. In fact, I leapt through it. I ran through it. And so for some of you, you may be currently in that position right now today where you're looking for a sign and you actually have the door standing right there in front of you. Like, baby, it's wide open. All you need to do is just walk through that sucker. Okay. So that may be your current situation. For the rest of you, here's a little checklist. If you're stuck in a day job, you want out of it, you want to know when it's a good time to leave, here's some things that you can go through to help you make a decision, okay? Number one, if you are someone who is married and you're considering leaving your day job, are you and your spouse in unity about this decision? Listen, I put this one first because I think this is so important. The Bible says where there is unity, there is a commanded blessing, okay? So having, you know, the same thought process as what your spouse does in terms of you leaving your day gig is key. That way there's no bitterness if things go sideways when the bills start rolling in and the income isn't there. As long as there's unity and you've decided on this together, that is a super great sign that you're on the right track. Okay. Number two, is your day job actually preventing you from really being successful in what you want to call maybe your part-time gig or your side gig or your side hustle or whatever. Let me give you a great example. Damon Oates, who owns Deco Exchange, a lot of you know him as the Wreath Guy. Damon's been in my courses since last June, and Damon had an incredible job, an incredible six-figure job. He's a smart guy. He had a smart job. I think it was pretty cush, if I can say that. I think he had a good gig going, right? So he was able to be working kind of at the same time on his side hustle, et cetera. Damon and I had a conversation at my mastermind last year in Kansas City. And I said, you're going to get to the point where you need to quit that day job. And at first Damon was like, you know, I don't think so. I mean, it's such an easy gig. And it wasn't, but just a couple weeks later that Damon sent me a screenshot of his resignation. And this is why. That day job, that 8 hours that he had to go and sit there, was actually like almost like putting a plug on his side hustle. It was really preventing that thing from just going full speed ahead because he's tied up 8 days, you know, 8 hours a day doing something else. And so if you get to that same place where Damon was, where your day job is the one thing that's actually like preventing the snowball of your side hustle, then that is a really, really great indicator that you may be needing to leave that day job soon. So I'm super proud of Damon. And you have also seen Damon on several of my Facebook lives. Damon is now making over six figures a month on that side hustle. And so it can be done, my friends. It's completely possible. Way number three that is a good indicator of when it's time for you to leave that day job is when you feel completely double-minded. Listen, I can remember, you guys, when I was stuck at my day job, and I called it cubicle hell, and you're going to have to excuse the four-letter word there, but I felt just so stuck there. I felt like my soul was just dying in that thing. Like, I am so grateful for the people who are created to sit at a desk and who enjoy going to an office, who enjoy getting dressed up every day. I'm so grateful for the people who love to sit behind a monitor and, have a commute 5 days a week, but that is not this girl. Okay. And so I felt completely torn because I would be at my day job and I would be daydreaming about my side hustle. And I would be at that day job and I'd be thinking, gosh, I have so much I need to be doing at the other job. You know, I there's so much opportunity here and I'm stuck. And I just felt so like conflicted because I would be thinking about both jobs and trying to figure out how to kind of juggle these things, both in terms of hours and in terms of my energy. And so I just felt really double-minded. And it's interesting that the Bible talks about a double-minded man. He's unstable in all of his ways because we're not meant to be torn in two directions. And it's interesting when you're trying to do two things well, the truth is you can never do both really well. It's impossible to chase two rabbits at once, right? And so if you are feeling completely torn between your day job and your evening hustle, and you're feeling like you're very double-minded, and you're feeling like you're just chasing your tail, I'm here to tell you, you are. You are. And at some point, you might have to make the leap and just go all in on that side hustle. Fourth way you can tell that it's time to leave your day job. I love to ask entrepreneurs this question. Why are you staying at the day job? Are you staying for the wrong reasons? Are you staying out of fear? Because if so, that's not a good reason to stay. Are you staying out of guilt? Maybe you're working a day job for someone that you really love and respect, and you feel like, gosh, what a disappointment it's going to be when I turn in my resignation. Or maybe you work for a family member and it's going to be so hard to tell them you need to leave. And so you're staying for the wrong reasons. Are you staying for the perks? Are you staying for the things like the 401k? Because listen, I think that so many people fall into the trap of thinking that as responsible Americans, we're supposed to do the responsible thing and go to the 9 to 5 and have the 2 to 3 weeks of PTO a year and have the 401k with the company match and have the insurance and all the things. Listen, it's never been easier ever to get all of those perks outside of a corporate environment as it is now. There are different ways of medical insurance and medical sharing and ways that you can invest your money so that you still have similar things to what a 401k would have been. But those are some of the wrong reasons that people will stay at a day job for 6 more months. And that 6 months turns into a couple of years. And that couple of years turns into another decade. And before you know it, you always had this dream. You always had this potential to do a side hustle. But you stayed because you were scared to jump, number one. You felt guilty. And so you just couldn't jump. Or number two is you felt really entrapped by the shiny things and all the perks you were getting. So those, I think, are often the wrong reasons that people stay. Another way you can tell that it's time to leave the day job is when you're living in dread. Listen, you guys, dread is a ridiculous emotion. It makes me feel so anxious. I know anytime I dread something, my anxiety level just goes through the roof. Okay. It completely steals my peace. And my guess is that it does for you as well. So for some of you, you start doing this little dread dance on Sunday nights and you start getting that thing in the pit of your belly where you're like, crap, it's been such an amazing weekend. And now I got to go back tomorrow to a job I hate and I'm already dreading it. And it just turns into this tornado of emotions that definitely is not good for your emotional well-being or for the people around you for that matter. I love how Joyce Meyer says that dread is the kissing cousin to fear. They're all very much related. And so if you are living in dread, I want you to seriously examine your life right now. And I want you to really look at the ways that you could make it into a life that was no longer something that you dreaded every Monday morning. Do you realize you will have 1/7 of your life spent on Monday mornings? Life is way too short to spend 1/7 of it completely in dread. And so if you're living that way, just very anxious about your day job, just dreading it all the time, your peace is absolutely stolen. And it's a really good sign that you need to really look at your current situation and figure out how you can develop an exit strategy so that you can get out of that day job. All right. Last way I want to talk about real quick. The last way to know when it's time to leave your day job is when you look at what you're doing in your day job and you realize that you're actually stealing from them. Now listen, for some of you, this is gonna hurt, okay? And I was guilty of this. I just wanna say this up front, all right? So when I was at that computer information systems job, and I was still there 18, 19 years ago, but I had started my side business on the nights and evenings, I would literally sit, you guys, and use company time to design my business cards. And I would sit and use company time to Google things like beautiful textured walls. How do I make columns look like marble? I was using my employer's time, and it wasn't a small business. It was a corporation, but still I was using their time to build my side business. And I know that this is going to sting a little, but I felt so convicted at one point that this is not honorable to the people who are currently employing me. They're paying me to sit here and work on their business every day. And instead, I'm sitting here working on my business every day. So it's no wonder that I actually got laid off because I wasn't doing anything. So if you're in that situation where you're literally just keeping a chair warm Monday through Friday and you're using your employer's time to build your own business. I want you to really look at that and remember just the golden rule to treat others the way you want to be treated. And I got to a time when I was felt so convicted about doing that. And then luckily shortly thereafter was let go. And so I hope that all of those reasons that as you went through there, that maybe it made you feel a little bit better in terms of knowing what are good indicators in terms of when you should actually be leaving that day job. So a lot of people will ask the second part to that question. How do you know when it's time to leave? Okay, so I gave you like six good indicators, but I always think that there's a couple other things that you need to make sure that you've got in place before you make the leap from full-time day job to full-time entrepreneur, okay? Number one, I want you to already be making some money at that part-time gig, at that side hustle, at that whatever. I want all indicators to be pointing towards the fact that you have potential to make up the income that you're about to walk away from, okay? So if you don't currently have that business name going, you need to get it going. If you don't have that Facebook page made yet for that business, you need to get that going. In fact, we have a great resource over on jenniferallwood.com where you can, it's a blog post that'll help you get to your first 1,000 followers on your Facebook business page. So if you haven't done that yet, go check that out. But you need to be making some money so that you, so that the market is showing you that there's potential for this business to be successful, okay? You also need to have what my friend Nicole Walters calls an exit strategy. You need to have a plan. Okay. You need to be thoughtful in this, and your plan needs to include something like when it gets to X date, then that's going to be when I leave my day job, or when I begin making X amount of dollars, that's when I'm going to go ahead and leave the day job. But there needs to be some sort of a strategy there, again, that you and your spouse, if you're married, have decided on and have agreed upon. And then you need to go from there. Third thing you're going to need is you're going to need 20 seconds of just insane bravery. You're going to make the decision to leave that day job, and then you're going to feel like a crazy person. And I will also just forewarn you, you may have friends and family who are not in complete support. You may not have anybody else in your circle who's an entrepreneur. You may be giving up an incredibly good career to do something to them that appears foolish. It appears irresponsible. It appears crazy. But let me tell you this, when you feel like you're getting that nudge from the Lord to make the leap, and all signs are, you know, pointing in your favor that this is going to be something you can be successful at, you're going to have to get so laser focused on tuning out the opinions of others and just paying attention to the lane that God's asking you to stay in. So listen, I'm excited for some of you who I know have been in your day job for so long, and you've got that feeling in the pit of your belly where you know it's probably time to leave that thing, but you're just waiting for somebody to give you the okay. Listen, if you're in unity with your spouse, if that thing is preventing you from being super successful on your side hustle, if you're feeling double-minded about having two jobs, if you're staying at that day job because of all the wrong reasons like fear and guilt, if you are dreading your day job on a consistent basis or stealing your employer's current time, those are all really good indicators that it's time for you to make a shift. So I know for all of you, it's a scary thing. I don't want to downplay the importance of a decision like this, because it's a big, important decision. Some of you are single mothers and you are, you're currently your sole breadwinner in your house. And so making decisions like this, they're huge, all right? And so I get it. I absolutely understand. But I know that every single day of the week, I would rather bet on me and put all of my eggs into my own basket than bet on somebody else who is employing me, who at any time could cut my pay, cut my hours, or cut my position whenever they deemed necessary. And so listen, I'm rooting for you. I absolutely am. I hope that some of you listen to this podcast, and I hope you'll drop me an email and let me know that it touched your heart. And if some of you are, you know, recently have quit that day job to follow your dreams, I'd love to know about that too. Drop us a line. You can email us at any time at podcast@jenniferallwood.com. So I hope that that is helpful. And listen, we have got lots of other great podcast episodes coming up in the very new future for you. I want to just thank you again for listening so consistently. And if you get a chance, would you drop over to iTunes and just leave us a review and a rating? I wanted to just bring attention to a fun review that we got recently from Michelle Lynn, who says, I just finished listening to episode number 27 on outsourcing and hiring help. This is probably my favorite podcast thus far, Jennifer. You hit every single nail right on the head. I'm in your inner circle and your creator's roadmap. I'm listening to all your podcasts while I'm at home working at 1 o'clock in the morning doing painting for people. This is the work that I wish I would have hired out. So Michelle Lynn and Casey, I'm so glad you enjoyed that podcast episode. And thank you just for leaving that great review, because we appreciate it. And those reviews matter. So God bless you guys as you go about your week. I will be back next Wednesday with a new podcast episode. Until then, I hope that you'll stay creative. Bye-bye. Hey everyone, thank you so much for listening to the podcast. I'm honored that you took the time to be here. If you could, we'd love it if you could run over to iTunes and leave us a review. And then make sure you find me on Facebook, where all the fun is happening. Don't forget that we have show notes over at jenniferallwood.com. And until next time, I want you to stay creative. Bye-bye.